Bwana asifiwe sana. Hebu tusimame tusome neno lake Mungu. We'll read about 4 verses and we are reading from Habakkuk chapter number 2 verse 1 to 4. We are still praying that God will give us faith in the confusing time that we find ourselves. Faith that can stand the trials and the tests that are within us. Faith. But today I've entitled what we are sharing, "The Just Shall Live by Faith." Amen. All right, let's read together. "I will stand upon my watch and set upon the tower and will watch to see what he will say unto me and what I shall answer when I'm reproved. And the Lord answered me and said, write the vision, make it plain upon the tables, that he may run that readeth it. For the vision is yet for an appointed time, but at the end it shall speak and not lie. Though it tarry, wait for it, because it surely come, it will not tarry. Behold, he saw which is lifted up is not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith." If you look at that verse, we'll read it one more time, is that he's talking about Babylon. "Behold, he saw the king of Babylon, which is lifted up, is not upright in him." So you have to have that understanding. So let's read the whole verse together. "Behold, he saw which is lifted up is not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith." Look at 3-4 people, tell them the just shall live by faith. Give them a high five, tell them the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. Hallelujah. We may get seated. We've been building a case. And when we were talking about this verse, when we read it last time, I said this concerning this verse, and I know this service, they never had me, but the first service and the third service had me say it. That what happened to the writer here, he gets to a place and he discovers that God will do what only God can do. A baby will be born and a baby will go, because God is the only one who can do what he can do. Another one will stay for 15 years without a child, and at the 16th year, the Lord will give them a baby, because God is the only one who can do what he can do. Some of us will find ourselves in situations that we never bargained. It's only God who can do what he can do. We never bargained for divorce, but it happens sometime too early. We never bargained for death, and some happen so early. Some people get married, and as they go for honeymoon, either one of them goes, the other one is left. But it's only God who can do what he can do, because he discovers that God is sovereign. God is sovereign. He's the one who decides. No wonder he calls the Babylonian kingdom as bad as it is. And if you read chapter 2, the whole of it, from verse number 5, you will discover what it is. It was a terrible kingdom. And yet God calls it, "This is my servant." In other words, God can use anyone. And that's why I said last Sunday, the other Sunday when I was sharing it, I said, I am so blessed that God can use even the devil to bless me. Shetani mwenyewe uone amekuletea mkate. Na ulikuwa umeomba mkate. Sasa wacha ubishi, chukua mkate, kula, rebuke him. After you eat your bread. Because God can use anyone. You know, one of the truths that I know about God is that, you see, mlango unaweza fungwa na mtu. Ninaomba yule Mungu afungue yule mlango. Mungu hata tuma malaika, yule aliyefunga ndiye ufungua. You're not getting it. Umeandikiwa barua ya kufutwa. Unaomba Mungu aliyekufuta anaandika ingine ya kukuandika. May that happen to you. Amen. May those that have said evil things also turn around and be a blessing to you. Amen. Because God is sovereign. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Yes. Mungu hufanya vile inavyompendeza. A alipogundua hayo ndipo anaingia katika second chapter number 2 anaingia kwa vishindo, because he says this is what I'm going to do. Once I know the sovereignty of God, I will not complain, I will not murmur, I will set myself somewhere. You know, the biggest problem is when you are confused of the sovereignty of God because of something happening. Hizo ndege ndio ndugu yangu alitumia akaenda nayo. Na usidanganywe na mtu. When you take it off, you remember what happened to our brothers and sisters. You remember. It's not foreign. I'm coming from Dubai and we take off. The pilot is so good, man. He speaks so well. But he's a Kenyan pilot. And his first officer is a Kenyan. And he's so happy. He says, we are both from Kenya. Karibuni sana. Now in your mind, it is Ethiopian Airlines that comes into your mind. But cast is the man who trusts in another man. Because in the sea and in the air, it belongs to God. The sovereignty of God. Why it happens to others and it doesn't happen to others is only God who knows. Once you know that, your life will be blessed. Once I don't struggle with that, my life is blessed. Once I don't struggle with huyu tulisoma naye nilimshinda Kiingereza anaendesha gari sina. Once I know that God is sovereign, I will not struggle with that. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Oh, I will not struggle. My father, why did you die so early? I will not struggle with that. Why? Because I know God is sovereign. Why people go to the US? Others prosper and others don't. Sovereignty of God. Ama ujui kuna watu wenda America na hataki kurudi. Na ukienda ukimpigia simu hapatikani na mteja hapatikani kwa sasa. Na umepiga simu na hachukui. Sikupenda ni kwa sababu maisha yako hivyo, sovereignty of God. But there are others when you call anataka kukuenjoy, anakuchukua na gari moja mpaka I say bwana. Hey, na nyumba nayo wacha bwana. Iko na basement. You know the way they teach us. Hii nyumba yangu iko na basement bwana. Tunaingia kwa basement. Ai. Baka unasema, God help me, can I build a basement? You know, there are even some who believe that you cannot build a basement house in Kenya. It's only that they have not visited. Hata hapa Kenya zipo. But what I'm saying is the sovereignty of who? Of God. And those people that are blessed, they also know, yani ulinishinda hesabu, niwe tajiri, ni kuandike uwe accountant wangu. Now, as far as God is concerned, none of you is bigger than the other. All of you are fulfilling the purposes of God. When you know the sovereignty of God. Ati huyu, sani my boss, ameanza shule yake. Na huyu, kwa joyo, unagithu kudoi. You know, that kind of, I mean, it bothers you, does it? But when you know the sovereignty of who? Of God. Then you relax. No wonder Habakkuk, because of knowing that, he gets to another, oh my goodness, that takes me to another thing. Why somebody would be in one place, then you relocate to another so that you can find your destiny helper, your destiny purpose. Some people have to go so that you can get room. You know, in other words, my bishop always says this, for Moi to come, Kenyatta had to. You don't pray for them to go, but he had to go. Kibaki to come, Moi had. For that other pastor will be senior in this church, bishop has to. Sovereignty of God. Si useme. It is sovereignty of God. Kimani has to. Because we cannot be both of us here. Oh, I like that. Iyo imekukuta kwa mguu wrong, eh? But it is the truth of the whole matter. You know, we were trying to get a permit to build in Ruiru. We want to build a magnificent conference center. Barua yetu ikashikwa na mtu akakataa nayo Kiambu. Right? Vile anakataaga nazo. Bishop wetu akasema, hatutatoa kitu, hao ndio watatoka.
Yule alikuwa amekalia ikawa moto akafutwa. Sasa juzi nimeenda governor ananiambia, "Katele kama udukao niko hurumu no. Whatever it is, as far as I'm concerned, he has no idea somebody had to go." Now look at your neighbor very well, tell there are some people who some people have to go. Kuna watu lazima wahame. Sasa na useme ukijua anayeweza kuhama anaweza kuwa your beloved. Now seriously, if it is a sovereignty of God, then ule wa kuondoka anaweza kuwa ni yeye, yule kipenzi chako. But it is the sovereignty of God. Once you know that, your life changes. Ah, hiyo ni poa sana. I like that. So in this message, we need to hold the two texts together because one is the key to the other. The just shall live by faith. In Romans 1 and verse 17, the Bible says, "For in the gospel the righteousness of God is revealed, a righteousness that is by faith from first to last, just as it is written, the righteous or the just shall live by faith." Note the last part of that verse where Paul says, "just as it is written." That means he's quoting an Old Testament phrase. Habakkuk 2 verse 4. "Behold, his soul is puffed up. It is not upright within him, but the righteous shall live by his faith." So everyone agrees that that statement is key in the Bible. No wonder Paul tries to explain it in the book of Romans 1:17, Galatians 3 verse 11, Hebrews 10 and verse 38. He tries to explain the same. The just shall live by faith. And you know, this text actually changed the world. The text changed the world. It first changed the man, and the man changed the world. And my prayer is that this statement will change you, and then it will change your circumstance. Because you will know, I don't have to do nothing. I am saved by grace of God, and I'm going to heaven by the grace of God. Once I know that, then my life is okay. I will not wait for people to tell me. To tell me, because already I know. Blessed be the name of the Lord. The man that was changed to change the world, his name was Martin Luther. Martin Luther was a monk in a monastery. And you know, some of you, when I take you to the encounter, some of you argue. Kwani hapa? Kwani ni monastery ya kitu? Because in a monastery, what people do, they keep on reciting prayers and asking for forgiveness. From the day they enter, they're asking for forgiveness. And they pray, recite prayers. They don't talk to one another. They pass one another with the, they cover their head and they are all praying. They are all praying, going up and going down. And Martin Luther, it happens that he was also in prayer. He was in Rome. But as he went praying and fasting so that he can be perfect, like some of us who think when we pray, when we fast, is when we perfect ourselves. But that's not the truth. When he was doing that, down in his spirit, for the first time, he remembered reading a scripture in the Bible. Romans chapter 1 verse 17. "The just shall live by faith." He left Rome, went back to Germany. Because that one changed his thinking pattern. I pray that it will change you too. When you discover that it is faith, nothing else. Nothing else is only faith. What happened to Martin is that he discovered many years ago, the church, you used to buy your right to heaven. Many years. You paid some money. So I would come to you when your mother is about to die, and I would ask, "Do you want us to pray for your mom to go to heaven?" Who will not want? Who? Who will not want their parents to go to heaven? Actually, the question we ask, who you are taenda? You know those questions. When you know your maybe your father, your mother, your brother were not living right, the question we ask us are, tutaonana kweli? You know those kind of. So if somebody comes and tells you, "Don't you worry, we can turn the tide around. Make him go to heaven straight. We'll put him somewhere where he can seek for forgiveness, be praying and fasting for a couple of years, and then he'll just go to heaven." but you had to pay. Now, what used to happen is that the poor would go to hell, but the rich would go to purgatory. Because the rich would pay for themselves. So when he discovered the just shall live by faith, it was freedom, changes thinking, and caused him to know even the poor, as long as they know Jesus, the just shall live by faith. Look at your neighbor, tell them, neighbor, the just, they shall live by faith. So it turned him around, it changed him, then it changed the whole world. And you know, the battle that the Catholics had with the Lutheran was because Lutheran came and said, you can even know right here if you are right with God. Why? Because righteousness is given to us by him that is righteous. No one is righteous, but God imputes into us righteousness. So he says, when the Spirit of God came upon me, that's what he said, I understood this word, the just shall live by faith. Then I felt born again like a new man. That's how he fell, Martin Luther. Left that place and ran away back home to Germany. His life was never the same. The little phrase, the just shall live by faith. But you know, what Habakkuk is saying, he's saying this. I know that God is going to bring deliverance. No wonder he says a few things. Maybe if you can pick this. Verse 1 to 3 of chapter 2, there are 5 keys to hearing God's voice. You know, prophetic dreams and visions. Hearing the voice of God is the birthright of every born again person. But what are the keys? Number one, meet with the Lord regularly in a special place of prayer. He says, I will stand. In other words, I will stand my watch. I'll be praying. If you and I want to move from where we are and in our living for God and living in faith in God and in our prayer, we must have a specific time, a specific place that we are meeting with God. He says, I will stand and I'm going to watch. He has gotten to a place, you know, the sovereignty of God. Then I will have to stand. I will not be moved. I will not be moved. I meet with the Lord regularly in a special place. He says, I will stand my watch. Number two, look for God to speak to you in your dreams and vision. He says, I will watch to see. In other words, don't pray without watching. Watch to see. Pray and watch to see. Be in a place where you can relax like Habakkuk gets to a place. He has asked God questions. Now he sits down to listen to God. Look for God to speak to you. He says, I will watch to see. Number three, listen for the word of the Lord. Listen for the word of the Lord. He says, I will wait for what he will say to me. Because God speaks. God speaks. When we talk about why, and we're not allowing God to say anything, actually I have discovered, the more I ask God why, and because there is no answer, I look for answers myself. And the first answer that I get quickly, I blame myself and blame others. If I was there, I would have done this. If I was there, he would not have gone. But you know what? The sovereignty of God is key. So, hearing God's voice is good for us to know that God will speak. Listen for the word of God, he will say to me. Number four, keep a journal of things that God is saying. In other words, you'll be blessed if you have a little book when you go for prayer, so that what you hear him saying, write it down. Write it down. Don't let it pass. Just write it down. Know this is what God is saying. Write it down. And then keep a journal, write the vision. And lastly, wait for God to bring it to pass. It will surely come to pass. But you know what? This is what he says. This is what he confessed. This is what he wrote. But friends, it took 70 years for Babylonians to be crushed. So there are some of us that we have journaled. We have written down what God has said. But some of us, it has taken 10 years, 15 years even to have a baby, 7 years to have a baby, 3 years to have a baby, and so on. Some of us, it looks like it has taken forever. But the other day, you are 25. So you have not waited for long, but you have not found the person to marry you, and you are 30. So you have waited for only 5 years, if you like. But it looks like forever. But write it down. If God says it, it will come to pass. I like that. You know, I like that because there was a lady, friend of mine, who one day told me, my year to get married is this year. And I looked at her. I wondered, kwani utamchukua kutoka wapi? But you know, she was not speaking from that level. She was speaking from a level of faith. This year, I will get married. 4 months down the road, she comes and tells me, I have found him. He's a good man. 10 months down the road, he came and said, we cannot get married to him. He's a cheat. But I will still get married because God says I'll get. Actually, she did. She refused to be married by a cheat. Can I dwell there a little bit? Some of us confess it and a cheat comes around, but we kind of say, hata wiu ataokoka, atampenda. If she is a cheat, he will always be a cheat. So you'd rather give him the cake. Akule nusu, na ukule nusu. Muachane kabla mjaenda mbele ya mchungaji. But if God has said it, I think the key word is, if he has said it, he will bring it to pass. Some people wait until they are 60, but their right man still comes at 60. Why? Because God is not a cheat. What he says, he will do it. Oh, I love God. I love him. You see, for 70 years, Babylon continued looting, continued harassing, continued beating, continued conquering. But Habakkuk was told, you have heard what I've said now, write in big figures. Andika mtu akikimbia anaona kwamba siku moja, Babyloni amehukumiwa kwa sababu yeye anakasoro. But the righteous, the just, shall live by faith. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Their end is determined, but it won't happen for a long time. But their end is already determined. Now, if you know that, if you know the just shall live by faith like Martin Luther, then whatever evildoers, even when they come to power, the evildoers, what do you say? The just shall live by faith. In other words, hata kukikosa mvua, you know, kunaweza kosa mvua. Kwa sababu tushagundua hata inaweza nyesha na chakula kikosekane. But the just shall live by faith. Watoto wetu wataenda chuo kwa sababu watapata kazi, because the just shall live by faith. I hope you are getting what I'm saying. Me, I'm already getting excited about it. But the just shall live by faith. So, even when we pray and a corrupt guy gets it, ata masiyes, waingie tu, na unajua hawaibi milioni, ata sikuizi wamekua watu, ata sijui, ebu muangalia jirani yako wambie, kaya duma hana atia, what's the problem with the people? They are stealing billions. Moses, billions. Don't they understand that with 1 billion only, billion more? Miaka sabini na tatu na miezi kadha, unaweza ukua ukila milioni moja kila mwezi na aishi. Hebu nikupe vile unaweza kuwa ukifanya, kwa sababu milioni ni kubwa. Kila mwezi unarudisha Mercedes yako 350S whatever class kwa Ditidobi, na unawapa milioni moja, wanakupa ingine mpya. So for 73 years and point something, unaweza kukiendesha gari mpya. Sasa wanaiba bilioni, paka unashindwa. Kwani una tumbo ngapi? Utaendesha gari ngapi? Ndege ni gani? Hata, you know, mtu kweli, I don't know. You know, just the other day when the daughters of faith were in Kabarak, and maybe this year they will also, as they go to Kabarak, the bishops might go to say hi to Moi. You know Moi is not well. Si ukimwangalia unaona hana afya sana. If you sit down, that guy is speaking of building a hospital that will be the largest in Eastern Africa, across Kabarak. If you have been to Kabarak, kishamba hiyo ingine opposite ni yake yote. Na, ataijenga kubwa kwamba itakuwa rifaro, na atakuwa na center zingine. Moja Meru, alitaja. Baka ukajiuliza. Kweli. Kinyari, when? I know they quote a scripture in the Bible which is kule tuendako akufanyagwe kazi. Kwa hivyo kazi ni hapa. What, you know, the question is, what do you do when your prayers go unanswered? You answer back and say, the just shall live by faith. That will sober you up. What do you do when your dreams turn to ashes? You dreamt this and it has all gone to ashes. Then you can say, the just shall live by faith. When you see trouble on your hand, the righteous man remembers that God is still on his throne. And when the dark clouds break overhead, he says to himself, the just shall live by faith. In other words, your life becomes, it has a purpose. Why? Because the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. That verse which changed Martin Luther is the verse that I want to bring to you by sharing 3 points. That's Romans 1:17. For in the gospel, a righteousness from God is revealed. A righteousness that is by faith from first to last, just as it is written, quoting from Habakkuk, the righteous or the just shall live by faith. Number one, this righteousness, number one, it reveals a righteousness that comes from God. The word righteousness comes from the courtrooms of the ancient world. It means to declare not guilty. And to declare someone innocent of all charges. If you are righteous in God's eye, you can stand before him because you are not guilty. You are not guilty. You are righteous. But righteousness, you also know that you cannot buy, you cannot earn it. You receive it. It's Christ who gives it to us. He gives it to us. And let me say, this is what we all need. We need righteousness. This is what we need. But many of us don't have it. That righteousness that you feel, I don't have it, but the just shall live by faith. I don't feel like I'm okay physically, but the just shall live by faith. That's what we need. We need to know that. The reformers had a special word for that. They said, what we need is alien righteousness. Righteousness that comes from another place. And righteousness we have has come from Christ. You know, when we visit other countries, like when Daktari was in Canada, I know he discovered there is a line that has Kathalika. The queue for Kathalika normally with their passport, whether it is e-passport, e-visas, whatever, is longer. The other one is shorter. Because the question you are asked with a smile from the guy, the immigration, is that, welcome back. Did you like where you went? Was it okay? Welcome back. Yao inaenda mbio mpaka. You feel tempted. Why can't I go to that officer? That officer looks so good. If you go there, you will discover for you, because you are an alien, utakaa hapo maswali utaulizwa 40. Unaenda wapi? Address ya kule unaenda ni wapi? Utakuwa ukiishi wapi? For how long will you be? Yani, when I'm away, I normally look forward to when I will come to Jomo Kenyatta, because they will ask me the same. Uliko kwenda bwana, kulikuwa aje? Kulikuwa na amani? Karibu nyumbani? Yeah, It's so easy. Karibu nyumbani. Karibu. Oh, that I say, wow. Like yesterday. Oh, I went very fast. With all my luggage. Umetokezea wapi? Ah, karibu nyumbani. Hakuna kitu cha kudeclare. Hakuna karibu nyumbani. Mpaka nikafikiria, hawa watu wanafikiria namna gani wakiona nina... If I had the time to tell them, that's the way I was feeling when I was in your country. But this is my country. The same thing is true. The righteousness that you and I have is from Christ. And we are free. We are declared free. It's like asking, kule umetoka kuko na amani? Na saa hiyo unajua kuku ana chakula. Unasema yeye kuna amani kwa sababu haki yake imenitosha. Niko complete na yeye. Once you discover that secret, my brother, my sister, your life, you will never compare yourself with anyone. Hallelujah. My hope is built on nothing else than Jesus' blood and righteousness. It's the truth. And that brings us also to the next question. The righteousness from God is received only by faith. Only by faith. The key word here is faith. Our text says that righteousness is received by faith from first to last. It is by faith. We receive it by faith. We receive it by faith. You know, to illustrate this point, is to ask, do you know that the seat that you are sitting on, you are heavier than it? Did you know? Did you check? You just start by faith. Wow. That's what faith is all about. So I'm talking to people of faith. You drove your car here. You had faith it will take you where? But you know they break along the way, but you knew it will take you where? And even if it can break along the way, you would say something like this. Wewe gari, lazima utaundika. Kwa sababu kule ninaenda, lazima unipeleke. You know that kind of a thing. I started by saying, me, I'm always amazed by the heaviness of the plane. Have you ever thought about how heavy the plane is? That thing is huge. And every time it is on the runway, I am amazed. Hicho kikitu kina halafu kinafanywa kakitu tu. Kikitu kinaanza kupanda. Kinapanda. Kinapanda. Unaona kule chini unaacha watu tu. Tu vitu tunaanza kuwa kunapanda. Baka ninasema huyo Mungu anayepeana hiyo hekima, huyo ndiye Mungu. Imani ninayotaka ni ya huyo Mungu ambaye hicho kitu kimebeba maji na chakula cha hawa watu. Nao watu wataenda choo huko juu. Kitaongeza uzito pale. Mizigo yao iko kule juu. Na hicho kitu bado kinapanda. Na kisha panda, kimesha panda. Now the other place that amazes me is when it is coming down. We have 15 minutes to landing. Now that again amazes me. Tena kinafanywa kitu. Kinaanza kuteremka. Kinakuja. 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 Alafu unasikia kimeguza. Kidogo tu. Alafu. Mnasikia you have landed. What amazes me, and I thought about it this morning when thinking about sharing with you. And I think I need to do more research on it. Wale walianza kutengeneza ndege walikufa watu wangapi? No, ni swali tu. Kwa sababu kikishaenda na unataka just like so like this man who entered akasema mimi naweza endesha ndege. Si nasema ukienda ufanye hivi. Ndege ilipoanza kwenda mbio akafanya hivi ikapanda. Ikiwa juu akaangalia karatasi inasema vile inaweza akakuta hakuna. Page ilikuwa hiyo tu ya kwenda juu. So how do you come down? So I was thinking, there must have been many people who died. But you know what? Even as more died, they still worked on it. Why? Because they knew it's a better mechanism to take people from one place to another. Can you imagine? Iyo trip yetu imechukua wiki moja kwenda India ingechukua siku ngapi? Meli hapa tutoke. Wiki moja mpaka Yemen. Yemen. Wiki ingine mpaka huko Dubai. Wiki ingine ili tuende India. Yani karibu mwezi. Kwani mnaniangalia kama mnashangaa. Mizigo yako ikitoka huko China inachukua siku gapi? Hapana siku 28. Lakini haka kitu, we took breakfast in India. Supper we took in Nairobi. That's how easy it is. Is that scaring? Woo! Faith in God. Why? Because he is God of the sea. He is also God of the sky. He is God of the land. Awesome. Awesome is our God. So that is faith. So here I'm talking to people who have faith. Faith in God. We have faith in God. Thirdly, by the righteousness in the gospel, men and women are declared just in the eyes of God. And that's why to prove this, Paul quotes from Habakkuk 2:4. He said, the just shall live by faith. I said this is what changed Martin Luther. His young son, the youngest son, called Dr. Paul Luther, in 1544, said this as a testimony. My late dearest father, you know, after he left the monastery, he went and married. The other church in India is Catholic. They are all over the place. Actually, one of the ladies that was serving me was a Catholic, and she was so happy. So when I told her I'm a bishop, she said, Catholic bishop? I said, no. But then she insisted I have to bless her. And I did. I blessed her. And she did this because I'm a priest, you know. And the other guy that was taking us around, he's a Hindu. So he would introduce us. Now, this is a father, and this is a bigger father, and this is a boy's father. Because we had Bishop Mark. So I am big father, the boy's father. This one is. But this is what this young man said, narrated the whole story of his journey to Rome. He acknowledged with great joy that in the city, through the Spirit of Jesus Christ, he had come into the knowledge of the truth of the everlasting gospel. It happened this way. As he repeated his prayers on the Lateran staircase, the words of the prophet Habakkuk came back. And he started saying, therefore, the just shall live by faith. And he left Rome, running back home. Why? Because the just shall live by faith. He went saying, sola fide, faith alone, faith alone. Faith alone, not by works of law. Faith alone, not by obedience to the church. Faith alone, not by human righteousness. Faith alone, not by baptism. Faith alone, not by good intention. Faith alone, not by sacrament. Faith alone, but not acts of charity. Faith alone, plus nothing, minus nothing. He left Rome saying that. And they thought he was crazy. He wasn't crazy. He just discovered that if I'm going to live in Kenya, the just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. The just shall live by faith. One man called George McDowell debated on a well-known Muslim. And at one point, the Muslim tried to ridicule the Christian faith by saying that Christians are riding on the back of a crucified man. That Christians, they are riding on the back of a crucified man. So Joas replied by saying, you are right. We are riding on the back of a crucified man. And he is going to take us all the way to heaven. God is going to take us all the way to heaven. Only trust him. I want to finish by these three things. Only trust him. That statement, only trust him. Only trust him. We are talking about faith. The just shall live by faith. Only trust him. The word only, this is the right qualification. That I'm not going to depend on any other thing. I'm only going to depend on God. That becomes my qualification. si kwetu, si watu wetu, si nini, ni yeye tu, peke yake. Trust. Trust will be the right action. What I need to do is to trust. He's the right qualification, but all what I need is to trust him. And the word him, he is the right object. Only trust him. The right qualification, the right action, the right object. Only trust him. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We are called only to trust him. Only trust him. Only trust him. He will save you. He will save you now. Only trust him. Only trust him. Blessed be the name of the Lord. I want to finish at that point. And I want to ask, maybe you're here. And you remember where we started, the why, and so on, the many questions that we have no answer. And we have known that all what we need is to know that because you are a just, you are going to live by faith. The just shall 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 live by faith.